Thank you, Lasca Hurlock, and thank you, Minister, for being in the Shannon today. I would firstly like to thank the many survivors and their advocates and allies who have contacted myself and other members this week in relation to this bill. I haven't had a chance to go through the more than 4,000 emails I've received since Monday, but I and others have heard the concerns expressed loud and clear. There has been a strong reaction for a reason. We are legislating in an extraordinarily sensitive area, where we are beginning to the process of trying to come to terms as a society, as a state and as a parliament with the incomprehensible horrors of what occurred in mother and baby homes across this country in our all too recent past. The importance of the kind of records we're discussing here cannot be understated in helping us to understand, to memorialise and to reconcile with that shameful part of our history. These records will play a crucial role in the national process that we are engaged in, to build narratives built on historical and intergenerational justice and that appropriately and sensitively memorialise the women and children who were resident and lost their lives in these homes. What happened to them in homes like Tuam cannot be forgotten or swept under the rug. It must be remembered in all its shameful detail to honour their memories and the experiences of the survivors and their descendants. As a result, how we manage these records, how we manage access to them and who we give responsibility to for holding them for safekeeping is vitally important. This goes to the heart of the legislation for us. And to comment briefly on Senator McDougall's statement on privacy, I think we've learned from the likes of the retention of record bills and others that survivors are not a blanket group. And if I'm correct, there wasn't a waiver to waive anonymity. There wasn't an option. So we assumed anonymity. We did not give people an option to waive anonymity. So I'd like to be very clear on that. Minister, I'll begin by commenting on the process that has been used to progress this bill through the Shannon. Forcing a bill through the Shannon in this area that's so sensitive in a single week has provoked significant and, in my view, justified reaction. This bill does not move through here in a vacuum or without the context of what has gone before us. As you know, in the last Shannon, we had legislation before us on adoption and information and tracing, which unfortunately stigmatised and belittled adopted people. It's clear that the damage done by that bill is still raw, and I do think we're seeing that reflected in the strength of the reaction this week. So taking an extra week to allow for additional debate in the Shannon would have allowed for more consultation with survivors. This has unfortunately been a central complaint of how this bill has progressed. Being seen to move too quickly or without due scrutiny on legislation like this does damage our credibility with the public and particularly the survivors that are affected. In terms of the bill itself, Minister, the concerns will be familiar to you. Any pronouncements around a 30-year sealing of records will always be a cause of concern, particularly coming so soon after the intense debate and eventual withdrawal of the Retention of Records Bill. We need to listen to survivors when they tell us that they want to access their own personal information and testimony. That is something that we should be able to guarantee them. Where appropriate and sensitive memorialisation is the aim, then efforts should be made to anonymise records for their inclusion in crucial historical projects, such as for the proposed archive to be built on the site of the Magdalene Laundries on Sean McDermott Street. We are concerned this will not be possible under this bill. There are also real concerns about the legislation and GDPR, particularly how data subject access requests are currently being denied by TUSLA on spurious grounds relating to the conduct of future commissions. How can a survivor being able to access their own personal records harm the conduct of a future investigation? However, the central concern here is that TUSLA will be given control of these records despite their track record, their extremely conservative interpretations of what should be released under GDPR. There are also concerns around how appropriate the Commission of Investigation Act 2004 is for sensitive investigations such as these. In 2017, statements in this House on the setting up of this Commission, many of us called for the Commission to sit in public, a request which was ignored. These are just some concerns, Minister. We will be discussing them in further detail at committee stage, where we will be tabling amendments. I'd finish by restating the importance of moving and legislating sensitively and respectfully on these issues. All of us here will play a crucial role in deciding how this shameful part of history will be remembered, and we must take the responsibility seriously. Thank you.